Hey, it's Jang here from the unofficial LEGO Hero Factory Mocks blog with a look at the Series 4 or Breakout Series Furno from LEGO Hero Factory. This is one of the three larger heroes in this series, and when you buy it, you get a code for 300 game points in the free game at herofactory.lego.com. This is a 56-piece set. Comes in a bag like the rest of the heroes. So let's go ahead and open up that bag and see the parts inside. And there's the basic spread of them. Instructions go all the way out to page 27. Let's take a look at some of the parts. First off, the bone pieces. Of course, you can just pause the video once I get these laid out so you can see exactly what's here. I'm not gonna go through every single one because they're pretty obvious what is here. You get some in black, some in the dark gray. Put those aside. The body is using the standard sized hero body, so the one with the two ball joints here in the middle of the shoulders. And for armor, we've got two, just dropped one, but we've got two of these number five white parts here. And then this is a new color, I believe, for this shape. It's the wider size of armor, and these are in the bright red. You get one number five long piece in the transparent neon red, kind of orangish red. One of these villain pieces in silver, and let's see, a couple of red feet. One of these 3.0 add-on pieces in silver. Here's his main body piece. So this is Furno's fiery print for his version. It's the same color of red and using the same body mold as the others. Just has that different print on it in yellow with a little bit of black shadowing edge detail. He has only one actual hand, unfortunately, and it's a red one. He has a red colored version of this top part of the launcher. These two are pieces that have been around for quite some time, used in the system-based sets quite a bit. I think some Atlantis sets used these, but they're actually rather old. But there's two of these here in white, and those are going to be used for his turbines or underwater propeller devices. Impellers, I guess, would be the best term for them. Got two of those in dark gray. There's one more armor piece that I didn't see there at first. It's just a three long silver piece. The lower part of his launcher uses one of these shorter launcher pieces. Of course, he's got his hero cuff pieces. Here's another armor piece, three long in white. He's got one of these long spear pieces, and that's just in a plain medium gray right there. And a couple of these old tubes, the hollow tubes, moderately flexible in silver. I have not measured the length of these, but doesn't really matter too much to me. And then Glatorian head, inner headpiece in the translucent, transparent neon green, as they call it. It's just a greenish yellow. It's primarily, it's closest to yellow. It's not the new bright neon green version that they came out with. It's the older one that was, you know, same thing that we saw on Surge and such. And then his head, his actual helmet piece, is the same as the 1.0. Nothing new there. And that's in his nice bright red. So that's it. Let me go ahead and start building this up. You know, I originally thought that this set looked a little bit jumbled with the colors when I was just seeing the original photos of it. But now that I've actually built the thing, the Series 4 Breakout version of Furno actually doesn't look so bad. Seeing it in person actually starts to make a little bit more sense to me in terms of what they've done with the colors and how they all fit together. I think it looks pretty decent. Obviously very asymmetrical, so if you are OCD about symmetry, just don't get this set, okay? Just stay away from it, leave it alone. But if you're okay with asymmetry, because asymmetry is a very interesting and thought-provoking aspect of life in general and design of all things, living and not, then you will appreciate how they've armored him differently side to side. You've got a lot of this silver armor here. It's very bulky and has a lot of texture. It's not super bulky, kind of medium bulk, but it has a lot of texture because of the specific parts that they used. Over on this side, not so much bulk, but he's got the launcher on this side. So this is more of his defensive side over here. And obviously he is still right-handed, but I guess he would spend a lot of his time kind of looking to this side. Now that's a little bit weird with these hoses. They do kind of get in the way sometimes. You kind of have to tuck them away. The good thing about these hoses is that they will flex to a point and actually stay there if you overflex them. So if you overbend this, after a while of just continuing to bend it more and more, it'll start to get to the point where it won't come back and get in the way again. A couple things that I don't like about this set. One, the use of this translucent red piece right here. I don't think they really needed to do that. They could have either put just a regular bright red, the same as the rest of the colors. I think that would have worked out well. Or another silver piece over here just to kind of balance side to side a little bit. This feels a little bit random to me, that part, especially since you can just see right through it, right down to his bones, which doesn't make so much sense to me for a full-on regular hero, but it doesn't bug me too much. I like the fact that we got two parts with new colors here for the launcher, and obviously you can mix and match those with other parts from other heroes. And then this piece right here just adds kind of adds some texture to it, you know. They officially call it a harpoon, you know, obviously underwater spear thing. Doesn't really show the way that this is built, how it would shoot out, but the fact that it can be removed, it can be split out, you know, it's pretty decent playability to that. You know, you can take it out and have it sticking into an enemy. So that's pretty decent. And I like the fact that it's got a little bit of a kind of a gothic flair to it. You know, it's not just a plain, basic, straight bladed spear, so that's pretty cool. Looking at these things up here, these underwater impellers, I really like how they can rotate very easily, but they don't just kind of flop around. They do hold in place because they use the blue half pin, half axle pieces that have a little bit of friction in them. So that's really cool. You know, you can just point it in the direction, okay, now he's going to surface, he's going to go up, and now he's, you know, maybe he's sinking too fast, or if he wants to move forward, you know, just kind of angle them like this, or even just for, you know, kind of flight underwater, like so. They do kind of impair the movement of the head. You kind of have to line this up just right to fit it in between these two pieces, because they don't have any side-to-side motion in those two ball and socket joints, so you can see it's kind of pinched in there. He's not able to really move his head entirely into a fully horizontal position, but it's pretty close, so it's not too bad. You might want to move these back a little bit further just to get a little bit more motion available from the head. But it's good that you do have some options for posing them, so you can still get a lot of poses. It's just not always smooth to move directly from one pose to another. And again, with these hoses, they just kind of float around a little bit. But still, not too bad as far as the motion, the poses you can get. He's got his hero cuffs over here. It's a good length. It's attached in a good place. It's not dragging on the ground like with Surge. All in all, not a bad figure, not a bad figure at all. There are definitely some things that some folks will just subjectively not like about him. All in all though, pretty decent figure, pretty decent character, especially if you hadn't really followed along with previous versions of Furno and you just saw this for the first time. You know, thinking of it just as it is, without any history behind it, it's a pretty good action figure. You know, it's a good size. It has a fair number of parts, has a lot of things that can move on it. The colors stand out pretty well. Again, I don't like this one particular thing, but that's just one small little thing. All in all, I do like Furno, and I hope that a lot of folks out there who get Furno will do some customizations to make him even more personalized and maybe add a little bit more armor to him, change the color scheme out just very slightly, you know. Just play around with different things that you can do with him. Or if you like him just like he is, well, there you go. And now you've seen exactly how he'll look in real life, so to speak. So thank you very much for watching this review. Please subscribe Lego Jang on YouTube if you have not already. And check me out on Facebook if you have a Facebook account. And be sure to follow the blog at hero-factory.blogspot.com. And I'll catch you later.